I will describe this one conversation happened between me and Arunagiri Yogeshwara, what Arunagiri Yogeshwara taught me. And then I'll translate also, even if I am not able to translate, I'll give the gist in English. So listen, listen to this very clearly. I was sitting with Arunagiri Yogeshwara. He was explaining about the tattvas, prithvi tattva, jala tattva, agni tattva, vayu tattva, akasha tattva, and alignment of tattvas. Once the Pandya kingdom was facing the poverty due to the lack of rain, all the four countries, Chola kingdom, Sera kingdom, Tondai kingdom, all four, Pandya kingdom, all four, Pandya, Chola, Tondai, Sera, all four was going through very tough time, and all four were under the Pandya at that time. That time the Pandya kingdom was the ruling of all four. At various times one became more powerful than the other. So, but at that time, the incident I am describing, at that time Pandya kingdom was ruling all the four. There was no rain, and the life line of all the four kingdom got affected, because the life line of all the four kingdom is dependent on the rain. The agriculture in Chola kingdom, pearl harvesting in Pandya kingdom, the elephant grooming, taming, not grooming, grooming is not the right word, elephant taming in Chera kingdom, producing enlightened beings in Tondai kingdom. All four were affected by not having rains. How the pearl harvesting and producing enlightened beings are connected to rain, that was the unique connection explained to me by Arunagiri Yogeshwara, my guru. He said, the pure water of the rain entering into the shell makes the core for pearl into that, the mother pearl, what do you call the English name, whatever. I am describing the whole concept. You understand what I am trying to convey? And same way, it's a rainy season, the minds of the beings, so calm, fresh and alive, gets into higher states of samadhi and achieves enlightenment. That is why the rainy season between Guru Purnima and Navaratri is always dedicated for enlightenment in all the sannyasis' lives. So listen, Tondai Nadu, Tondai was the land of sannyasis grooming and exporting it to all over the world. Bodhi Dharma is one of the examples. He was groomed there and then sent to China to teach this great principles of Sanatana Hindu Dharma. Neither the word Bodhi is Buddhistic, nor the word Dharma is Buddhistic. Both words are staunch Shaivite Hindu words. Shaivite Hindu words. Bodham is a Shaivite Hindu word. Bodhidharma lived and left as pure Kanchipuram Tondai Mandala Adi Shaivite life. Later on the history got distorted as And portrayed is a Buddhist, and of course, it's not Buddhism is away from Hinduism. It's part of Hinduism. It's okay. It's just a different sampradaya internally. If one of my brother claims, hey, he's not your brother, he's my brother, I'll tell, hey, he's brother for both of us. Come on. That's it. That's the way Hindus behave. Come on. Let me come to this subject. For all four, rain is required. Because of the lack of the rain, all four were suffering. So Pandya goes to Chokkanada and asks Chokka, Ireva. Ireva is the beautiful, sweet Tamil word for intimately calling Paramashiva. Like Amma Yappani, Ireva, Chokka. These are all the colloquial way the Paramashiva is addressed. So he calls Irayani. Immediately, Paramashiva appears and asks, what do you want? So, king describes, see, all the four kingdom, all the four nation is suffering in poverty because of no rain. Please bless. Then, Mahadeva, Paramashiva gives a beautiful sutra, 60 sutras on sexology. Irayanar Kalaviyal. You will be shocked. What is this? Problem is not having rain. And Paramashiva gives the principles of sex and sexology. And principles of what is chastity and all that. But fortunately that Pandya did not have stupid binary logic. He was ready to listen to Paramashiva and he received the teachings and took it and started spreading all over the country, all the four desas. Within 3 days, rain started. Within 3 weeks, the rejuvenation started. Within 3 months, poverty disappeared. Arunagiri Yogeshwara explained this science to me. Understand? The earth element, water element, fire element, air element, the space element inside us, if that gets imbalanced externally also, all those elements gets imbalanced. If that is balanced internally, everything else gets balanced externally also. At that time, the immediate requirement was the whole society coming to the balance of chastity. When they brought the karpu, the chastity, into their life, suddenly all the external tattvas got balanced and the whole nature blessed. The wealth, richness, bliss, happiness, prosperity, everything started happening.